I'll sit.
As I begin, I just want you to take a moment to reflect on your life. What comes to mind when you do this? I'm sure a lot of memories, experiences, and lessons come rushing towards you. Things you've done, things you wish you've done, and things you wish never happened. And then, who comes to mind? I'm sure a lot of people, maybe your friends, your family, or your neighbors. People who have helped you on your journey called life. But I'm also guessing that when you do this, one person stands out among the rest. This someone is a person that has been with you through thick and thin. This someone is a person that has guided you and helped you when you needed it. This someone is a person that has given you a shoulder you can cry on and memories to last a lifetime. To put it simply, you can't imagine your life without this someone in it. Let me take a moment to tell you a little about this someone in my life. This someone has been with me since the moment I was born. She's been there holding my hand for as long as I can remember, and even before then. She has raised me to be the person I am today, and God willing, will continue to help me to be the person I will be tomorrow. I can't imagine my life without this someone, and actually, I literally wouldn't have life without her. This someone is my mother. I lived with my mom for 18 years. For some of you, that may not seem like a long time, but for me, it's literally my whole life. As I've grown older, I always waited for the day when I wouldn't want to be around her. It wasn't like I was looking forward to it. I just thought it was part of life and everybody got to that point. I've seen it happen on TV, in movies that I've seen, books that I've read, and even in people's lives. I'm sure you all know what I'm talking about. It's when you get to the age that the mom that raised you is no longer as cool as you once thought she was. You feel like she's always telling you to stand up straight, iron your clothes, clean your room, and wash your face. And the last is the worst when you don't do it right, because then she licks her thumb and cleans the stuff around your mouth. Then there's the most dreaded of all, the kiss in public and the I love you that sounds too loud, and you feel like everyone around you heard it. And that's when you may come to the point when you never want to be seen in public with her. When I became a teenager, I waited for all this to happen. I waited and waited and waited, but it never really came. And that got me wondering why she didn't embarrass me so much that I couldn't bear to be seen with her. But when I look at the kind of mother and woman she is, it all seems pretty obvious to me. My mom is mindful. She's one of the most thoughtful people I know. She's constantly thinking of others and putting herself second so that others can go first. She's always looking for ways to help out. She's a mother of six, and that alone means that she has a lot on her plate and a lot on her mind. And yet, she continues to do things not only for us and for my dad, but also for other people in and outside our family. When I think of how she's always looking out for others, one thing always comes to mind that proves to me just how mindful she really is. My grandpa, who was her father, was diagnosed with Alzheimer's when I was about 3 years old. When he became too bad to live by himself, he moved to an apartment underneath below my uncle's house. And my mom would go every day to help him, make sure he was cleaned and dressed and everything like that, had eaten. But when he got really bad and couldn't live alone anymore, my mom wanted him to come live with us. And we had just moved into my house about 2 years before then. And we had 8 people there already, my mom, my dad, 5 of my brothers and I. And we kids ranged from about 19 years old to about 2 years old. But she knew that it was in the best interest for Pop for him to come live with us. She wasn't thinking about how hard it was going to be on her or how much more work she was going to have in taking care of a man who was slowly losing his memory. She was thinking of how much easier it was going to be for him. He lived with us until he died, and looking back, it was hard and many times irritating, but I wouldn't have changed it for the world. My mom's thoughtfulness and selflessness in this case, and countless others, has shown me the graces and gifts one receives when you open your arms, your heart, and your mind to what others need. My mom is intelligent. Seeing as she homeschooled my 5 brothers and I at one time or another, from every grade, from kindergarten to high school, goes to show just how gifted she is. Now, if you ask her, she'll probably deny this. But I know it's true. She's always learning and passing on her newfound knowledge to my brothers and I. Her intellect goes further than just schooling, though. She knows so much about life, and that's what I found to be the most helpful and beneficial. I can go to her with any kind of question or concern, and she'll have an answer or advice for me. That's not to say that I listen all the time. We won't get into this because it's about my mom, not about me. But it's with this knowledge and experience of hers that I'm really able to learn. It's from the mistakes that she tells me she's made and the opportunities she's told me she overlooked that if I listen carefully, I won't do the same. She's taught me so much about life, but also, and this I find the most important, she has taught me about God. She has done this in two ways, by word and by action. Our Catholic faith is a subject that we discuss on a daily basis. It's not something we bottle up and only open on Sunday morning when we step into church. God is talked about in our everyday conversations, over dinner, in between TV commercials, and before bed or in the morning. And through these conversations, I've learned a lot. But then we also have the expression, actions speak louder than words. And that works perfectly in my life. By watching my mom, I've observed the ways of a woman of God. I've seen how one should act and how one should live. And I do my best to live by her example and remember all that she has taught me. My mom is nurturing, always ready with open arms to let me or anyone else in. And I don't think there's one person that my mom couldn't take care of. She's ready to help me on my way and get me back on my feet whenever I need her. I used to run to my mom when I was little, and I'm not ashamed to say that I still run to her today. I used to go to her when I was hurt, and she would handle it and heal me. Now, many of my wounds are internal, and a band-aid won't help, but my mom still does. It's her words and wisdom that work wonders for me. The problems that I have in my life, when I feel like I need to talk to someone, she's the first person I think of, and she's the first person to lend a listening ear. My mom is always there to offer a hand to help and to heal me when I need it. My mom is everything to me. Without her, I have no idea where I would be or who I would be. I'm a product of how she raised me. She taught me almost everything that I know, and I'm eternally grateful for that. If it weren't for my mom, I can't tell you how different I would be or what I would be like because I can't imagine it. I can't imagine my life without her in it. It's like thinking of your favorite book or your favorite movie without the main character. It wouldn't be the same. It probably wouldn't be the most enjoyable. As enjoyable, it would change everything. Now, as I've gotten older, I get told a lot that I look or act like my mom. And now I'm beginning to see it in myself. I know we're not supposed to be proud, but sometimes I can't help it. When someone tells me that I look like her, I feel honored that I'm being compared to someone that I hold so close to my heart. It's like getting compared to your role model or your hero. It's actually exactly like that because it's exactly what she is to me. This is my mom in a nutshell. There is so much more to her, but this gets to the root of who she is and how I see her. To put it simply, let me spell it out for you. My mom is mine. She's mindful, intelligent, nurturing, and everything. All that she is adds up to what I see her to be. There isn't anything that I would change about my mom because I don't see the point. She's the perfect mother for me. Now, there's no need to get defensive when I say that. I didn't say best mother ever or perfect mom, because I know a lot of people can get a little bent out of shape when they hear that. They instantly get tense because someone dared to assume that their mother was superior to theirs. But that's not what I meant at all. I meant exactly what I said. My mom's the perfect mom for me. She's been with me through thick and thin. She's guided me and helped me when I needed it. She's been the shoulder I can cry on and has given me memories to last a lifetime. She's my someone in life.